nataka nichukue nafasi tena kumshukuru sana Rais wa Jamhuri wa Kenya ambaye pia ni Amri Jeshi Mkuu Mheshimiwa Uhuru Kenyatta, kwa vile ni yeye ndio ameweza kutusaidia ili tuweze kupata hili kiwanja katika hapa sehemu hii. Lakini sasa tukiwa na International Airport itachukua pengine dakika 20 na mgeni aweze kutoka hapa na aweze kwenda across Tanzania na endelee na safari yake. Kwa hivyo International Airport inakuja na benefit nyingi, sio tu kwa watalii lakini pia kwa wenyeji hapa, kwa jamii. Sasa ile kazi utaanza, kwa sababu ndio contractor hapa, ile kazi yote ambaye local anaweza kufanya hapa, ajiri vijana kutoka hapa. Kwa hivyo wale vijana ambaye wanatoka hapa yote sasa watapata kazi. Si namna hiyo bwana Wambogo? Si hiyo ni kawaida? Na pia materials yote, hakuna materials unaenda leta Rongai ama wapi. Ile vijana wana supply vitu, sijui nini nini, yote materials unapata hapa. Hizo ndio benefits. Sasa itabidi watoke na lami yote kutoka Lemek, kutoka Kilgoris, kutoka wapi, kutoka Kiminde, tuko Kirindoni. So hii infrastructure hii yote, hasa utaambia waziri afungue hizi barabara yote, access roads, kutoka Soit, kutoka Kirindoni, kutoka Lolgorian hapo, kutoka Angata Barigoi, kutoka huko Aitong, Lemek. Hiyo access rote ndio watu wakikuja wanakuja mara moja wakienda.
Air connectivity is essential for the development of any tourism destination. It has been noted that when a visitor plans a holiday, one of the factors that they look into is ease of travel. Over 80% of tourists in Kenya travel via through JKA, Moi International Airport, and Wilson Airport, and connect to other domestic airports. Majority of these visitors include Masai Mara in their plans, and hence the importance of improved connectivity for this destination. It will ensure ease of travel and contribute to upgrading of the Mara as a tourist destination. The airport will also play an important role in environmental conservation through reduction in the vehicles throughput within the Mara, thereby ensuring that potential degradation of our habitat is well controlled. The rehabilitation and upgrade of Agama Airstrip will be in three distinct growth phases, with the ultimate goal of having a fully operational international airport. We are launching phase one today. This will entail the following: rehabilitation of existing 1,260 meters long runway and expansion of the width from 18 meters to 23 meters to facilitate code C aircraft operations. Construction of a new apron. Runway of construction, including addition of a new surface layer of bitumen. Repair of the damaged runway edge markers and repainting of the runway, and then fencing of the airstrips. Phase one of the project is expected to cost 278 million Kenya shillings, with a project implementation period of 12 months. Phase two will cover the extension of the existing runway from 12,060 meters to 2,500 meters and the width from 23 meters to 30 meters. It will also include construction of a VIP lodge and associated mechanical and electrical works. Phase three will entail construction of a new runway of 3,300 meters length and 45 meters width, associated civil works, construction of a terminal passenger building approximately 4,000 meters square, and associated civil works.
Appreciating the tremendous support we have received from the tourism stakeholders, the Ministry of Tourism in particular, and also to pledge as Kenya Airports Authority that we'll continue working with all those stakeholders as we begin this journey until we complete the upgrading of this project. We also had excellent support from the National Lands Commission in facilitating matters to do with land acquisition, the county government of Narok through the leadership of the governor. We've had excellent support in realizing this dream, and we continue working with Your Excellency and your team to actually realize the dream.